So now we're going to look at integrating factors. Integrating factors is a way that you can solve ordinary differential equations that are not quite exact, but they seem really close. So really the best way to do this is to start off with an example and then give you a whole bunch of theory. So look at this example here. So we have 3x plus 2y squared dx plus 2xy dy equals 0. Now, we know, theoretically, that d dy of this one should equal d dx of the second one if we want to use the exact theory, the theory of exact, whatever, differential equation stuff on it. Now, if we do this here on the left, we get 4y squared. We get 4y, but on the second one, we actually just get 2y. So you go, who knows? They're actually close, but not quite. So the question is, what could we do? Now let's say we had a magic fairy. Magic fairy of happiness and lonely math people. So magic fairy says, how do you spell fairy? How about that? Says, multiply the whole thing by x. So let's pretend that we do what the magic fairy tells us to do. So really what we end up with is 3x squared plus 2xy squared dx plus 2x squared y dy. You say, well, why would I care? Well, now look what happens. If I ddy the first term, I'm going to get 4y, still, or 4xy. And if I ddx the second term, I'm going to get 4xy. And I go, oh my gosh, they're the same. Yay. And now I can use exact equations on it. But the question is, what happens if you don't have a magic math theory? What do you do? If you don't have a magic math theory, then you have to use integrating factors. So this is going to walk us through a little bit of the theory behind how to be your own magic math theory. Yay! And then you can spell it however you want because you're the fairy. So let's say that we have m dx plus n dy equals 0. We're going to magically multiply the whole thing by u of m, or u times m, u's a function of x. So we've got u m dx plus u n dy equals 0, like that. Okay, now we're going to use the same kind of theory that we used before, where we said that I'm going to assume that partial f partial x of f is equal to u m, and that partial f partial y is going to be equal to u n, like that. And we also said, to be exact, that the d squared dx dy has to be equal to the d squared dy dx. So that means that basically the idea was if I ddy'd this, I should get the same thing as if I ddx'd that. So that ddy of um has to be equal to ddx un. You're like, okay, great, this just seems like it's going to give us more algebra, which isn't really the problem. I'm not having a problem with not enough algebra. Anyway, so basically, I've got du dy m plus u dm dy. And these are really d's, they're partials. That has to equal du dx times n, come on, plus u dn dy dx. You're like, wow, if only I had thought of that, it's so much clearer now. You're like, oh, sad. Okay, so now we're kind of stuck. And we're like, okay, well, before we said that you could be anything, let's pretend that u has to be a function of x only, okay? So if u is a function of x only, that means that the partial derivative with respect to y of u has to be, what? What does it have to be if it's only a function of x? It has to be 0. Why do we care? Well, we care because if we look at this equation here, I'm going to call this equation star. If we look at equation star, does that look like a star? We'll call that equation star. I guess it's a star. It didn't make it any better. So that means in equation star, du dy is 0. So that gives us 0 plus u. Now, here's a notation we're going to use. Instead of saying dm dy, we're going to say m sub y. That means a partial derivative of m with respect to y. It's just kind of a common notation. Same thing for dn dx. N sub x. Okay, so sorry, just fancy notation you got to get used to. So my equals partial u partial x of n plus u n x. You're like, yeah, this still isn't helping. I know, but just pretend. Okay, you're still here, and that's important because paying attention to the theory is, like, you know, important stuff. Nx minus my. Like that. So, how about 1 over u du is equal to nx minus my over n dx. You're like, this is amazing. So, generally, that means that my solution is going to be some unknown constant times e to the integral nx minus my n dx. And you're like, that's amazing. Okay, but here's the cool part. So we said that u was going to be a function of x only, okay? So that means that this also, since this is u, this up here has to be a function of x only. So actually what we're going to do is we're going to check, so after we check the first thing and it doesn't let us do it, the next thing we're going to check is nx minus my over n, so is this a function of x only? If so, then we're going to guess, then multiply the whole original equation, entire original equation. I don't write very much, but I feel like it takes forever when I do. Then we want to multiply the entire equation by u, and in fact we don't even worry about the constant because it's just going to add more junk that we're going to have. It's all going to cancel out anyway because we're just multiplying it. Then we want to multiply by u, where u is defined as this whole thing right here. And you're like, okay, that's great. But what if it isn't a function of x only? What if it's a function of y only? Glad you asked. Yeah, totally. Totally glad you asked. You're like, but I didn't ask. Does that mean the video is over? Remember, you're doing this because you want to. You're in college because you want to be in college. You're learning Diffie Q because you want to learn Diffie Q. So I'm going to use this equation here. Hold on a second. Okay, so there we go. So then the next part is to say, well, the first time we assumed that u was a function of x only, what if u is a function of y only? Now, can you set things up where u is a function of both x and y? Yes, I just don't want to do that much today. So for today, we're going to assume that x is always a function, u is always a function of x, or u is always a function of y. So if u is always a function of y, then what do we know about du dx? Well, then it better be 0. So that means that this thingy, du dx, goes to 0. So I've got that du dy times m plus u my plus u n x. Oh, sorry, equals. There's an equals somewhere. Here we go. Plus equals. So du dy m u n x minus m y. Come back. So this is what you get for free videos on the internet. You get random stuff that may or may not be helpful, but maybe this is helpful. Nx minus my over m dy. Now we know that the standard form of this is that u is going to be equal to e nx minus my over m dy, like that. And remember what we said. We said that u is a function of y only. So the only way that u can be a function of y only is if this here, not even the integral part, just the integrand, how's that for a fancy word? This also has to be a function of y only. So we would check, and we'd say, okay, if, just like last time, if nx minus my over m has only y's, then you want to multiply whole equation by u, where u is defined by this thing right here. Kind of make sense? Okay. And you can use one or the other. If they both happen to be, if one is only y and one is only x and it's what you wanted, then great. And you can use either one. That doesn't normally work out. So just to prove where a magic fairy came from, I'm going to copy this one and look at this one just to kind of show you. Okay, so this was our original problem. The first one, this is partial m with respect to y. This one is partial n with respect to x. So we said that if partial my minus partial nx is over n is a function of x, use that. So let's check that one first. So we have my is 4y minus nx, which is 2y, over n, which is 2xy. We get 2y over 2xy, and indeed that gives us 1 over x, so we are going to use that. If we use that, let's scoot over here, that means we're going to do e to the integral 1 over x dx, which is e natural log x, which is just x. And if you remember, that is what we multiply the whole equation by, and it worked. Yay! Now just to show the other one doesn't work, I'm almost positive it doesn't work. So try, it's nx minus my over m, and this has to be y. So that's going to be 2y minus 4y over 3x plus 2y squared, and that's where we're going to run into trouble. So clearly this is not just a function of y, so we can't really do anything with that. But we were able to find the integrating factor using the other method. So that was pretty awesome. So this is definitely something that you want to take a look at and get some practice. So here's all the theory. I'll put together another video. We'll actually solve that problem all the way through just for the experience, and do one more just so you can get some practice.